Good morning, my dear students. Today, I am going to extend my last lecture, which was going on extensive reading. The topic of this today's procedure of extensive reading. The procedure of extensive reading can be flexible depending the situation. In the words of Thomson and Twitt, the exact procedure advisable to adopt will depend upon the nature of the subject matter to be read and the skill in reading, which read all the skill in reading which already has been acquired by the class. There are three main steps for extensive reading. They are step one. In step one, introduction. The teacher shall give some main hints of the passage. The teacher gives briefly explain the difficult word. The teacher should deal with special difficulties of the language. And step second. In the step second, silent reading. Silent reading means the student reads silently but quickly. In the silent reading, student should pay much more attention on the reading. And the third step and the third procedure is questions. The teacher asks a few questions to judge if the students have understood the meaning or not. While following these steps, the following 2 points should always be kept in the mind of the teacher, as advised by Thomson and Twitt. Number one, the matter read must be understood by readers in order to increase interest. And number two, the matter should be read rapidly, otherwise interest will flag. I think, my dear students, you can understand the procedure of the extensive reading. Now, I am going to discuss about the advantages of the extensive reading. Advantages. Advantages of extensive reading. Number one, it helps in assimilation of ideas. Number two, it keeps the whole class busy and active. Number third, it increases vocabulary. And number four, it has high transfer of learning value since it prepares students for library reading. And last one is, it paves the path. study and self-affirmation. My dear students, it has so many advantages, but unfortunately in India not much emphasis is given to extensive reading. Proper attention must be paid towards this fact, and judicious place should be given to extensive reading in lesson plan. My dear students, I think that you may understand the procedure and advantages of extensive reading. So, if you are very inquiry, you may ask questions in the comment, and I request you please subscribe the channel of the Sonavati College of